Yes, Bhante.
Okay. Now, let us listen to this stanza recited by this monk.
Sabbathave sappurisakchajanti nekame kama lapayanti santo sukhena putta athava dukhena no chavacham pandita dasayanti
Again,
sabbathave sappurisakchajanti nekame kama lapayanti santo sukhena putta athava dukhena no chavacham pandita dasayanti
again.
sabbathave sappurisakchajanti nekame kama lapayanti santo sukhena putta athava dukhena no chavacham pandita dasayanti.
Okay, now let us recite it in my, old voice. It is difficult to stop when the other young monk recite. So we know, in order for us to learn the stanza, let me recite line by line. This long lines of different rhythm. Sabbathave sappurisa chajanti.
Sabbathave sappurita sajanti.
Nakama kama lapayanti santo.
Nakama kama lapayanti santo.
Sukhena putta athava dukhena.
Sukhena putta athava dukhena.
Na uccavacam pandita dasayanti.
Na uccavacam pandita dasayanti.
No. Again, sabbath ve sappurisa chajanti.
Sabbath ve sappurisa jayanti.
Nakama kama lapayanti santo.
Nakama kama lapayanti santo.
Sukhena putta athava dukhena.
Sukhena putta athava dukhena.
Na uccavacam pandita dasayanti.
Na uccavacam pandita dasayanti.
Okay, two line by two line. Sabbathave sappurisa chajanti. Nakama kama lapayanti santo.
Sabbathave sappurisa jayanti. Nakama kama lapayanti santo.
Sukhena putta athava dukhena. Na uccavacam pandita dasayanti.
Sukhena putta तातवादुतेन नावच्छावचन्ति पंडिता दशयन्ति।
राइट टू
सब्बत्थवे सपुरी साक्षजन्ति नकाम कामालपयन्ति सन्तो सुखेन पुट्ठा अथवा दुखेन नोचावचं पंडिता दशयन्ति।
Could you repeat it after him, just like he did?
Sabat-tave-sat-purisa-jayanti Nakama-kama-lapayanti-santo Dukena-putta-atavadukena Naucca-vacam-pandita Dasayanti.
Dasayanti.
Okay, now let us see the meaning. Okay, Sapurisa, the true people, Sapurisa. Here you can see Sapurisa. Actually, Sapurisa, instead of true people, we must say people with integrity. People with integrity. Sabbatha, everywhere. Where, surely, or indeed. Sapurisa again. True people. Chajanti, renounce. Chajanti, renounce. Na, do not. Kama, kama, desiring sense pleasures. Lapayanti, talk of. Santo, the good. Sukhena, by pleasure. Putta, when touched, putta. Athava, or dukena, by suffering, na uccha avacham. This is how this is combined together, uccha avacham. Na uccha avacham. Neither elation or depression. Uccha means elation. Avacha means depression. Pandita, the wise. Dasayanti, show. That means the true people surely everywhere renounce the good. Do not talk of desiring sense pleasures. When touched by pleasure or suffering, the wise show neither elation nor depression. That means when we study the story, this whole meaning will become clear to us. Let us see the story. The story is when Buddha was alive, the first after attainment of enlightenment, during the first 20 years, one day the Buddha with many, many monks went on looking for a suitable place to observe Vatsa. That means every year, 3 months, fully ordained monks and nuns stay in one place during the rainy season. In India, rainy season begins in July, middle of July, and end in October. During that time, it was very difficult to travel. One thing is very heavy rain. Second is all creeks, rivers are flooded. Lot of little plants are crushed if they walk. And therefore, they decided, Buddha made the rule that all the monks, holy and nuns, stay in one place. During that time, people can bring dana, food, and they listen to Dhamma talks delivered by the Buddha or these monks. So the Buddha and monks always don't stay in one place altogether. These monks can stay in their own place. But this occasion, Buddha and many monks went for looking for a place to observe Vatsa. Then there was a Brahmin called Vairanja. Then he inquired the Buddha and other monks where they were going. They said they were going looking for a suitable place to observe Vatsa, rainy season. Then this man invited them to stay in his place, Vairanja. So the Buddha and these monks accepted the invitation and stayed there. But this Vairanja Brahmin was supposed to take care of these monks with food, lodging, medicine, and so forth during that 3 months. But unfortunately, this man forgot it. He forgot it. And then it was very, very difficult for the Buddha and these monks to spend that Vatsa season without food. At that time, if monks went on Pindapatha, they received very little food, sometimes no food. And this man also, although they are not supposed to go on Pindapatha, but since it was so necessary for them to have a meal, they went, and people were not ready to give them anything, so they didn't receive anything. Meanwhile, some merchants taking a lot of wheat for their horses to feed their horse. And they found out that Buddha and these monks did not have any food, so they offered them with this wheat, only wheat, for each monk and the Buddha. And then this Buddha and these monks ate only this wheat, husked wheat. It is just like rice, uncooked rice. And Venerable Moggallana said to the Buddha, Venerable Moggallana had a very special supernatural powers. He said, Venerable Sir, I go using my supernatural powers. I take all of you to another very prosperous place every day to get dana. The Buddha said, no, 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 don't do that. Don't abuse your supernatural powers. We all must patiently stay these 3 months here and we will eat whatever is yet. Then after that 3 months, the Vairanja Brahmin remembered that he had invited this, the Buddha and this monk. So he came and rushing to him and felt very, very depressed, remorseful, regretted, and but the Buddha said, don't worry, we had this food and so forth. And during that time, all the beggars in that area also did not have much to eat. Whatever the Buddha and his monks left after eating this the wheat, they ate. So afterward, the Buddha and other monks went to, after 3 months, went to an area where they had a lot of good, delicious meals, and people offered them to the Buddha. And after that, these beggars in this area, homeless people, also began to eat. They ate, and then they were very jubilant, because now they also have food, and they began to play, you know, sang songs, dance, and so forth. You know, all kind of things they did. Then Buddha said, these monks also began to talk about them. But the beggars were very jubilant, happy when they received the food. But the Buddha and the monks were not disturbed. When they did not have food, they were not depressed, not disappointed. When they had food, they were not jubilant. They were not showing any great pleasure for having food. So in both situations, at the time they did not get food, and the time they got food, they remained the same. And this is what is called uccha avacha, elation and depression. Normally, people are touched by the worldly state we call atta loka dhamma. Ordinary people, when they gain, they were happy. When they lose, they were unhappy. When they are famous, they are happy. When they are not famous, they are not happy. When they have happiness, they were delighted. Then they have suffering, they were depressed. But the Arahant, Buddhas, and so forth, they remained the same in all the situation. Labha, alabha, yasa, asasa, ninda, pasansa. Whether they are praised or insulted, they remain calm, peaceful, equanimous. That is what you see in the Mangala Sutra. Puttasa lokadhamme chittang yasa na kampati asokam virajam kemam etam mangalam uttamam. Lokadhamma means this labha, alabha, yasa, asasa, ninda, pasansa. The noble ones remain the same whether they receive something or not. So in this case, Buddha and these venerable Arahant monks all showed by their example how the noble ones behave. So, okay? So they don't have special desire for food. And whatever they take, they receive, they use it just to maintain their body. And he is not attached to anything, gain, loss, and so forth. Now, Santo, Santa means the noble ones, those who have overcome their greed, hatred, and so forth. Whether they receive food, robes, food, drink, good monasteries, bad monasteries, good sleeping places, or bad, they remain the same. They don't demand various things from people. They don't go from house to house saying that we have such and such a project. Would you mind donating something to finish the project? And they don't go to from house to house, asking people, how are you? How is your wife? How are your children? Whether they are in good health and so forth, in order to establish a special relationship. They don't do that. They simply stay in their monasteries. When people come and ask questions, they answer them, deliver Dhamma sermons, and they don't try to live a wrong livelihood, doing all kind of things to please people and get support and so forth. And this is the message of this stanza. And if you were to go through a lot of details, it takes a very long time. And therefore, this message is enough for people to understand the meaning of this stanza. The people surely everywhere renounce the good, do not talk of desiring sense pleasures. They don't go out and talk to people, I need this, I need that. They don't demand people. That will be overburdened. Instead, they are satisfied with what they have. They are content and remain very, very humble and simple. They don't press the rich to get more support. They don't go out to get support from influential people in the society. They treat poor, the poor and the rich the same way. That is the meaning of this stanza. So I like to you to recite it once again, listen to this stanza once again, and then I like you to recite it after that, one by one. Okay? Let me play it for you to hear, and then recite it.
Sabbathave sappurisacchajanti nekame kama lapayanti santo sukhena putta athava dukhena no chavacham pandita dasayanti.
Again.
Sabbathave sappurisacchajanti nekame kama lapayanti santo sukhena putta athava dukhena no chavacham pandita dasayanti.
Okay, I like to recite it line by line so that you will get the pronunciation when I recite it slowly, and then I recite two lines by two lines, and then once I play this monk's recital, and then I ask you to repeat, recite by yourself. Okay, repeat after me. Sambhadve sapurisa chajanti.
Sambhadve supurisa sajayanti.
Nakama kama lapayanti santo.
Nakama kama lapayanti santo.
Sukhena putta athava dukhena.
Sukhena putta athava dukhena.
Na uccha avacham pandita dasayanti.
Na uccha avacham pandita dasayanti.
Okay, two line by two line. Sabbathave sapurisa chajanti. Nakama kama lapayanti santo.
Sabbathave sapurisa sajanti. Nakama kama lapayanti santo.
Sukhena putta athava dukhena. Na uccavacang pandita dasayanti.
Sukhena putta athava dukhena. Na uccavacang pandita dasayanti.
Okay. Now, once again, I play this so that you can get the taste of this. I hope you will remember to recite it either exactly like him or exactly what how you like to recite.
Sabbathave sapurisa chajanti. Nekame kama lapayanti santo. Sukhena putta athava dukhena. No chavacham pandita dasayanti.
Okay, Maitri.
Sabbathave sapurisa chajanti. Nakama kama lapayanti santo. Sukhena putta athava dukhena. Na uccha avacham pandita dasayanti.
Good, good. Maheli.
Sabbathave sapurisa sajanti. Nakama kama lapayanti santo. Sukhena putta atnava dukhena. Na uccha avacham pandita dasayanti.
Good. Anoma.
Sabbathave sapurisa jayanti. Nakama kama lapayanti santo. Sukhena putta athava dukhena. Nocavacham pandita dasayanti.
Good. Nimi.
Sabbetava sapurisa sajanti. Nakama kama lapayanti santo. Sukhena putta athava dukhena. Na uccha avacham pandita dasayanti.
Good. Varuni.
Sabbathava purisa chajanti.
lopayanti santo sukhena putta atta vadukena na uttavacham pandita dasayanti.
Very good. Malit.
Sabbatha vesa purisa shayanti nakama kama lapayanti santo sukhena puttam attavadukkena na uccha avancham pandita dayasanti.
Okay, Upekkha
Sapurisa Chayanti Nakama Kamaya
Good, Philip.
Sambhatavepsa purisa chajanti nakama kama lapayanti santo sukhena futta attava dukkhena na uccha vacham pandita dasayanti.
Good, Satima.
Sapatave sapusa chachanti nakama kama lapayanti santo sukena puta atavadukena na
Okay, Shwanti.
I have a question.
Yes.
Second line, the word atha, the spelling says athna. Is there an extra n in that word?
I did not hear you well, Shwanti.
The second line,
Oh, yeah.
the word atha, athava.
Athava. Dukena.
Yeah, it says athna. That n, is that a mistake or should that be there?
Okay, good. Then Revata. No, Anuvada. Revata. Katukampula.
Sabbatave sapurisa chajanti nakama kama lapayanti santo sukena putta atana vadukena na uccha cham pandita dasayanti.
Good, Kasum.
Sabbatave sapurisa
chajanti nakama kama lapayanti.
Athanas.
Sabbatave sapurisa chajayanti nakama kama lapayanti santo sukena putta atavadukena naucha avacham pandita dasayanti.
Good, Maheli.
Bhante, I said it.
You said it in Hiro Yuku.
Sambhatave sapurisa chajanti Nakama kama lapayanti santo. Skena putta ata ata wa dukena na ucha avachan pandita dasayanti.
Good, Chandima.
Sabbatve sapurisa chadanti. Nakama kama lapayanti santo. Sukena putta attana dukena noka ava kam pandita dasayanti.
Okay, now we have only 25 minutes to meditate. So I like you to meditate with me. Let me see this. Okay.
Bhante, I did not recite.
Yeah?
I did not recite, Bhante.
You did not chant?
Yes, Bhante.
Okay, you then chant. What is your name?
Ruanti.
Ruanti, yes, yes.
Sabbat. Vesa purisa chajanti nakama kama lapayanti santo sukena putta atava dukena na uccava cham pandita dasayanti.
Okay, good. Let me see.
Bante.
Yeah.
I had a question before.
Yes.
The third word in the second line. Third word in the second line. It's atha, right?
Athava.
Yeah. The spelling is athna. Is that correct?
Athava. Athava actually is a mistake there.
Mm-hmm.
Very good that you put it, that show it, point it out. Atha, atha. Okay, let me delete it right now. Atha. Vadukena. Very good. Thank you.
And same in the English meaning part as well.
Yes, atha, atha, athava, yes.
Mm-hmm.
English word also. Okay. I'm so glad that you have very sharp eye. Okay. Let me see. Here it is. I'm trying to find out metta recital. Okay. Okay. Can you see the metta recital?
No, but no, Bhante.
Okay. Now you can see it?
Yes, Bhante.
Yes, Bhante.
All right. Let us recite. Let me recite metta and then we practice. We hardly have about 23 or 4 minutes. And anyway, let me recite it for you. May all beings be happy and secure. May all beings have happy minds. whatever living beings there may be, without exception, weak or strong, long or large, medium, short, subtle or gross, visible or invisible, living near or far, born or coming to birth, may all beings have happy minds. Let no one deceive another, nor despise anyone anywhere, neither from anger nor ill will, should anyone wish harm to another. As a mother would risk her own life to protect her only child, even so, towards all living beings, one should cultivate a boundless heart. One should cultivate all the world a heart of boundless living friendliness, above, below, and all around, unobstructed, without hatred or resentment, whether standing, walking, sitting, lying down, or whenever awake. One should develop this mindfulness. This is called divinely dwelling here. Not falling into erroneous views, but virtuous and endowed with vision. Removing desire for sensual pleasures, one comes never again to birth in the womb. Okay, let us meditate. We have 20 minutes. Okay.
By means of this meritorious deed, may I never join with the foolish. May I join always with the wise until the time I attain Nibbana. May the suffering be free from suffering. May the fear struck be free from fear. May the grieving be free from grief. So too may all beings be, from the highest realm of existence to the lowest. May all beings arisen in these realms, with form and without form, with perception and without perception, be released from all suffering and attain to perfect peace. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Now, friends, this is today's our Dhammapada discussion, and I see you next week. And I want to share metta with everybody. May all beings who are in hospitals, taken care of by doctors, nurses, and hospital staff, may they recover very soon, return to their normal life, and continue their Dhamma practice and attain liberation from samsaric suffering. May all the doctors, nurses, and hospital staff all over the world who take care of these people, sick people, and may they also, instead of their happy, their busy life, find some time to practice meditation and liberate themselves from samsaric suffering. May all those who have lost their loved ones in various places in the world, may they find some time to understand the nature of life. Separation from loved ones is certainly painful, and we know this, and we want to get rid of this pain and practice Dhamma, understand the nature of Dhamma, and attain liberation from samsaric suffering. May all those who are all beings in the northern direction, northeastern direction, eastern direction, southeastern direction, southern direction, southwestern direction, western direction, northwestern direction, up and below, all beings in these 10 directions be well, happy, and peaceful. May they all find time to practice Dhamma, practice meditation, and liberate themselves from samsaric suffering. And I hope you see you, I see you next week. All right? Okay.
Hi. Bhante, thank you, Bhante.
No, thank next you, Sarnai, Bhante.
Bhante, next week, you mentioned next week we're having the Zoom on Saturdays.
No, that's not the change that I get because I've been told that COVID is spreading in the Virginia area.
Okay.
And therefore, we have to be very careful.
Okay.
And we start that next year.
Okay, Bhante.
It's not that long.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay, Bhante.
Thank you.
Sarvam Saranai Bhante.
Sarvam Saranai.
Sarvam Saranai Bhante.
Sarvam Saranai, yeah?
Thank you, Bhante. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.